कैन यू टेल मी समथिंग, व्हाट इज कॉमन बिटवीन अमिताभ बच्चन, नंदन नीलेकानी, आमिर खान, प्राइम मिनिस्टर नरेंद्र मोदी एंड मेनी अदर सेलिब्रिटीज? और व्हाट इज कॉमन बिटवीन मेकअप साइट्स स्कूप वूप, योर स्टोरी एंड मेनी अदर प्लेटफॉर्म्स लाइक दैट? वेल, द मोस्ट इमीडिएट थिंग दैट कम्स टू द माइंड इज ऑब्वियसली द चेंज मेकर स्टेटस दैट ऑल दीज वेबसाइट्स एंड दीज पर्सनल एंड दीज इंडिविजुअल सेलिब्रिटीज हैव. बट देयर इज वन मोर थिंग दैट इज कॉमन बिटवीन ऑल ऑफ देम, इज दैट ऑल ऑफ देम एज पर्सन्स और एज इन ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस दे शेयर देयर थॉट्स थ्रू ब्लॉगिंग. सो टुडे वी गोना टॉक टू यू अबाउट ब्लॉगिंग. हाउ इज ब्लॉगिंग इंपॉर्टेंट एंड हाउ हैज़ ब्लॉगिंग एक्चुअली इवॉल्व्ड ओवर द ईयर्स एंड कम टू दिस प्लेस? इन 1994 द फर्स्ट ब्लॉग वॉज written by Mr. Justin Hall, who was a student in Swarthmore University in college in Pennsylvania, and what he wrote was an online diary in 1984. In 1987, it was Mr. John Barger who renamed online diary to a weblog, which means logging your comments on the weblog. In 1999, it was Mr. Peter Merholz who actually coined the term blog, much to our ease of communicating, who would keep on saying online diary or weblog. So this guy, he said that let it be called blog. Okay. Now in 2002, a very interesting incident happened. A certain Miss Heather Armstrong, who was working in a dot-com startup, she used to maintain her blog. And she would, her blog was called Deuce, some sort of a slang for dude. So she would call it D-O-O-C-E, Deuce. And on that blog post, she would put her everyday events at the workplace. If she's not happy with the boss, she would tell that on the blog. If she's not happy with the workplace timings, she would say that on the blog. Soon, the company also came to know that she's writing some satirical comments or some things that are negative about the company on her blog post, and she was fired for it. Boom, comes the term deuced. So if you are fired from the workplace because you have written something against the workplace on your blog, it is now called deuced. But at that time in 2002, this small incident, which seems seemingly small, just one employee getting fired, it actually caused a lot of stir in the online world. There were discussions, there were problems, there were discussions, and lot of people quarreled with each other on how she should have been treated post the blog. However, this mayhem, this chaos, gave a lot of prominence to the term blog. This culminated in 2004 in when Merriam-Webster, the famous dictionary that we often refer to after Oxford Dictionary, it called blog as the word of the year. Now, when it was called the word of the year and all these incidents had already happened, we would see a lot of blogging sites prop up. Some blogging sites that are prominent are WordPress, Blogger, Drupal, SharePoint, and Tumblr. So these websites are very common now, and they all took birth in the early 2000s when the term blog was actually gaining a lot of prominence. Today, there are almost 504 million blogs as on 2018, but the start was not so great. So if you go back to 1999, there were only 23 blogs all over the world, only 23 blogs. In 2006, there were almost 50 million blogs all over the net, which increased to 152 million, thrice that number, in 2010. In 2018, as per Statista.com, we have 504 million blogs and 104 million individual bloggers all over the world. Well, that's a huge number. Today, an average user spends almost 20 seconds to 37 seconds on a blog. That's the attention span that we have. The people who are writing those blogs are generally 50% male, 50% female. It's a very evenly distributed community of bloggers, of content creators I'm talking about. Bloggers are also used to write almost the average number of words per blog post earlier in 2004 was almost 800 words per blog. Today, if you are writing a blog or if you're planning to write a blog, it should be 1150 words per blog post. So the blogging community, the blogging as a subject, as a content for your individual marketing, personal branding, or for your business branding has actually evolved since 1994. Many times I come across a lot of people who ask me that, Ambuj, you write a lot of blogs in the travel domain, in the marketing domain. Should we also start writing blogs? If yes, then how should we start it? And what platform should we use? And would we be able to earn some money as well? Well, the last question comes in a bit of a low voice, but it always comes out. Everybody wants to know how to earn money. So I'm gonna give you a very practical advice on how to think before you start a blog and how to continue the process of blogging if you decide to start the blog. We have already shared what the blogging history has been like. And today, there are, again, I'm repeating the stats, there are almost 504 million blogs that we have, as opposed to 1.7 billion websites all over the net. So 504 million blogs, 104 million bloggers. So it's a big universe you'll be talking against. And most of the niches, if you would try to blog and would want to tap a niche, in generally that niche has already been explored. So you are actually working towards a universe which is already quite cluttered and competitive. So there are a few things you should know before you even think about starting a blog of your own. First of all, what are the platforms where blogging should be started? The most popular platform right now is WordPress. WordPress accounts for almost 30% of the total number of blogs all over the world. 30% are over there. Then there's Blogger, then there's Drupal, there's SharePoint, there's Tumblr. So these are the blogging platforms that you have. If you are going to spend time for blogging, you should be very well communicative in English. 70% of the blogs in WordPress are in English. Only 4% are in Spanish, 2.4% are in Indonesian, 2.3% are in Brazilian Portuguese language, and only 1.5% of the blogs are French. So even though the most the all over the world, the language stats might vary from this, but 70% of the blogs being in English tells you that you have to be very well conversant and very proficient in speaking in English and explaining a concept in English before you think about writing a blog. Next, if you're a blogger and you want to publish some good high quality content, you have to understand that you will be spending at least 3.5 hours to write one single blog post. 3.5 hours, which is like almost half the day. A working day would be 8 hours, right? And this would be 3.5 hours. People also go on to write for 6 hours. But yes, when you start writing with a lot of frequency, then obviously that time decreases from 3.5 hours to almost like 2 hours. Now I can pull off blogs in 2 hours each blog. I can pull off even less than that, I can do it. But that's because I've been writing a lot of blogs. Next, earlier in 2012, the number of words per blog post used to be almost 800 words. Now, the blog posts are a bit more longer in their word count, and now you have to write a blog post of almost 1150 words to get those keywords in place. Next, I'll be also sharing with you that if you are thinking about doing a blogging activity, there are a few niches where people might want to read your blogs. There is a fashion as a niche where people want to know makeup stats, makeup, how to do a particular makeup for marriage, how to do a particular makeup for a date, or things like that. This could actually end up you, when you do a lot of blogging in the fashion niche, you can see your future as somebody who's being called at an event for talking about the entire sector. This could be your future standpoint. Next is food blogs. There are a lot of food reviewer blogs who actually start blogging, and they also put posts of restaurant reviews on their Instagram or their Pinterest platforms, and again they become influencers in a matter of a few months or years, and then they are able to earn money out of it. That's how you earn money. Next is travel blogs. Travel blogs is some niche which has been explored a lot all over the world. Okay, even though fashion and food might be localized, but travel is more globalized in its format. And travel bloggers, I've seen many, many, many journalists and travel bloggers going on, going to a specific destination for marketing for the destination to talk about the salient points of that destination. So you actually go on fam trips. Fam trips are nothing but familiarization trips. These are trips that are arranged by the tourism ministries or tourism departments of a particular state or a country, and they ask you to come over, they pay your expenses, and you go, you review the places, and then you post them on your blog post, and your community also sees those blog posts and comments, and that place basically gets a lot of hits, website hits. Next is lifestyle blog posts. These are quite similar to fashion, and again you can actually be invited to a lot of events when you do such blogs. Next is fitness. Fitness is something which has been a norm, a rage, or a cult that millennials and Gen Z are actually addicted to. So fitness is something that is on their minds. They are doing online travel fitness videos. They are doing a lot of workouts. And that is one place where you can actually start talking about the supplements they should take or not take, the classes they should take or not take, the frequency of exercise they should be doing in a month, and you can build upon that as well. So fitness is something. Next is DIY, do-it-yourself blogs. Now, do-it-yourself blogs are typically for people who are a bit creative in nature. They want to know how something works and they want to try their hands at it, but they want a bit of guidance from your side to start those things happening. You can do those things, you can show them a bit, and you can put them on YouTube, and they will be following you, and they will be following you for the next updates. Some of these DIY would be also people who are talking about how to use Excel sheet, advanced formulas of Excel sheet. For example, if I didn't know how to use VLOOKUP functionality of Excel, and I went to this DIY blogger site, and I know how to do Excel VLOOKUP on Excel, or DSUM functionality of Excel. So I know all these things because of DIY content that I was following. Next is obviously, since for the past 5 or 6 years, political parties have also adopted digital platforms for its propagation. It's a cheaper and easier way to get in touch with your potential voters. And so there are a lot of political bloggers as well who are talking about the schemes of the government, who are talking about how the opposition is taking a stand on a particular issue, and they are able to create a niche and a followership for themselves, and even can be invited for a few events for example there's an event by Make in India. You as a political blogger might be called to the Make in India event to cover the blog, to write about the blog, and to stay tuned for further events of Make in India. And you know, you could have some good relations, and maybe if there's an event of Make in India in some other country, Uzbekistan or Israel or something, you might as well be called upon to accompany the entire department. So this is also one niche that you can understand. Now, when I told earlier that the time spent by any user on the blog is 20 seconds to 37 seconds. So the importance of starting off the blog very well is obvious. You have to capture the attention of the reader in the first 20 seconds of reading the blog, because understand that when he's scrolling through the blog on his cell phone or his iPad, the cell padding is very small. Now, when that cell padding is small, he would either wait for a nice line to come, a nice stat to come, or a nice picture on his cell phone or the iPad. Otherwise, if it's only text, and that's also redundant text, it's coming all over the time again, he would just skip through that blog. So you have to capture the attention of a user, of a reader in the first 20 seconds of writing a blog. So these are the things that you should keep in mind before you start blogging, or if you are blogging and if you're facing some blocks, writing blocks while blogging, these are the things you can keep in mind. And with that, I would like to close this video. Stay tuned for more updates from Ambuj Saxena in Social Buzz e-learning. Thank you so much.